today's video, we are going to be ranking every roller coaster at Kings Island. Since this is my home park, I have ridden every single roller coaster on here numerous times. But before we get started, let me just go over a few things. This is 100% my opinion, so do not get upset if your favorite roller coaster isn't very high on this list. And now, before we get to the countdown, I just want to go over two roller coasters that would be pretty high on this list if they were still in operation. Firehawk was a Vekoma Flying Dutchman that operated at Kings Island from 2007 to 2018, and I do 100% understand why this coaster was removed. It rarely had a line, and it was a maintenance nightmare. However, I really enjoyed riding Firehawk. It was super fun, and if it was still operational, it would rank at number 6. Vortex was an Aerodynamics custom looping coaster that operated at the park from 1987 to 2019. Vortex was the definition of fun. I loved it so much that I rode it 17 times in a row on a rainy morning in July of 2019. However, I do understand why they took it out. It rarely ever had a line, and I was one of the few people that actually enjoyed it. If Vortex was still operational, it would rank in at number 3. Starting off our list, at number 14 is the Great Pumpkin Coaster. There isn't that much to say here besides it's a classic kiddie coaster that does its job well. At number 13 is Flying Ace Aerial Chase. This is a Vekoma Suspended Family Coaster, and it's one of the worst coasters I've ever ridden. Yeah, you heard that right. Flying Ace Aerial Chase is one of my least favorite coasters, and that's because it literally does nothing at all and is extremely pointless. Kings Island has multiple awesome family coasters that will rank much higher on this list, but Flying Ace Aerial Chase just isn't one of them. Not to mention that it's also extremely rough. The train literally shakes throughout the entire layout, and this ride only goes like 25 miles per hour. I have no idea what happened there. At number 12 is Woodstock Express, the park's family wooden coaster that opened with the park in 1972. Woodstock Express is not a bad ride at all, but I could only rank it so high. This coaster does have a few moments of mild floater airtime that will surprise you. Other than that, this is the perfect family coaster. Not too tall, not too fast, perfect for the young ones. At number 11 is Invertigo, the park's Vekoma Boomerang. There isn't anything blatantly bad about Invertigo, but there are a few things that I dislike about it. First of all, going backwards through the Cobra roll can provide some headbanging depending on where you sit, and going backwards through the vertical loop is just flat out uncomfortable. It also doesn't fit into the park's lineup whatsoever, and its space could definitely be used for something else. Starting off the top 10 is Racer, and yes, I know that there are two sides, but I'm clumping them together since their experiences are pretty much the same. Racer is a rough ride. There's no way around it. You will get jackhammered all throughout its 3,400 feet of track. Throughout the layout, there are some moments of fun, floater airtime, but other than that, there isn't much to this 48-year-old coaster. Number 9 is Backlot Stunt Coaster. This is a Premier Rides family launch coaster that has some really good theming and is overall a really fun ride. The only real issue I have with it is that the seats are unpadded, so on every valley you get slammed back into your hard plastic seat. The coaster itself, however, does have a few intense moments here and there, and the theming and overall fast pace of the ride makes you forget that you're still on a family coaster. Flight of Fear takes the number 8 spot, the park's second Premier Rides launch coaster. This time it's extreme, and it has 4 inversions. The coaster's queue line and ride itself is very well themed. It immerses you into the space theme that they were going for. You may be wondering, why is Flight of Fear so low, down at number 8? And that's because it's rough. Throughout the entire layout, the train will shake back and forth and you have no control of it. However, not being able to see what you're about to go through in the dark still provides a really fun experience. At number 7 is Adventure Express, the park's Aero Mine Train that opened in 1991. This coaster is flat out weird. There isn't anything that's really traditional about it. From the weird pre-lift section to the strange terrain usage, as well as the fact that the layout is really weird. Also that there's more theming during the coaster itself than in the queue line and station combined. Despite the fact that it's really weird, it's also really fun. I have so much fun riding this coaster, it's honestly hard to explain. Many people may be thinking that I'm overrating this mine train, however, I just tell them to go ride it and experience the awesomeness of Adventure Express. Number 6 is The Bat, the park's Aero Suspended Coaster that opened in 1993. The Bat is overall a really fun ride. The swinging cars really add to the experience. Even though there is no theming, the coaster makes up for it with its large drops and intense turns. Despite the Bat's relatively short track length, when you get off of it, it does not feel like a short ride. It just feels like an overall awesome experience. Number 5 is Banshee, the park's B&M invert that opened in 2014. You guys may be wondering why Banshee is all the way down at number 5. Let me explain. Banshee is an absolutely fantastic coaster with one of the best first drops I've ever experienced, as well as an amazing layout. Almost everything about Banshee is amazing, except for the smoothness. For some reason, Banshee is actually a rough ride. For a while, I would have just called it a strong rattle. Now in 2020, I would consider Banshee to be rough. I have heard many theories on why it's rough, but I'm not going to go into those. I'm just going to say that Banshee is a rough ride, and if you're a first-time rider, you need to be expecting that. Despite that, I still love Banshee. The inversions give a good whip, and overall, Banshee is still a fun ride, even with the roughness. Number 4 is The Beast, an in-house-made wooden coaster that opened in 1979. If we are just talking about night rides, Beast would absolutely top my list. However, we are going off of overall experiences, so Beast will come in at number 4. Where to start with The Beast? The large size drops at the beginning send you diving down to the bottom of the forest and provide an awesome gut punch. Not to mention the insane lateral pack turns that are thrown in there throughout the ride. Also, you gotta love the tunnels that send you through complete darkness. The Beast has always gotten criticism for being rough and boring, but I just tell the people who say that to
shove it up your butt.
In all seriousness, people need to start realizing what an awesome classic that The Beast is. At number 3, we have Mystic Timbers, a GCI wooden coaster that opened in 2017. If you've known me for a while, you would know that Mystic Timbers used to be my favorite coaster at Kings Island. However, things have changed, and now I have two more coasters ahead of it, and both of them are steel. Back to Mystic Timbers. It is a fantastic wooden coaster providing great pops of ejector airtime as well as laterals mixed in there. The shed is kind of a disappointment, but it definitely beats baking out there in the sun. However, Mystic Timbers is not the only show in town. Number 2. Diamondback, a B&M hypercoaster that opened in 2009. With both Diamondback and Mystic Timbers sitting in Rivertown and having their entrances less than 50 feet away from each other, these two rides are perfect to marathon on a day that's not very crowded. Back to Diamondback. I don't understand why this coaster doesn't get more hype. The airtime is phenomenal. On every hill, you go floating out of your seat for a minimum of 3 seconds. It also has a great layout that extends far back into the woods. This is my most ridden coaster, having ridden it over 150 times. Even though Diamondback is an absolutely fantastic B&M roller coaster, it's not the best B&M in the park. Number 1. Orion, a B&M giga coaster that opened in 2020. I gotta admit, when Orion was first announced, I was not all that excited for it. I thought that the layout was extremely short and was just upset that it wasn't 300 feet tall. However, Orion is the perfect example of why you shouldn't make opinions on a coaster until you actually ride it. Orion definitely exceeded my expectations, and not only by a little bit. I was expecting it to be number 2 or 3 in the park. It ended up being my number 1 in the park and ranking inside of my top 5. I'm not gonna go too in-depth with Orion because I already have a full review of it and you can check it out on my channel. As of July 2020, Orion is my favorite roller coaster at Kings Island, and honestly, nothing else even comes that close. Well, that's gonna wrap it up for my video ranking every single roller coaster at Kings Island. Did you agree with the placements in this video? Probably not, but that's okay. Let me know your top 5 roller coasters at Kings Island in the comments down below. And be sure to like and subscribe for more content just like this on Hang Time Thrills.